I told you before to beware for methods that the world teaches you. What I mean is, the world will teach you ways how to deal with uncomfortable or even dangerous situations, but the methods of the world are worldly. They are self-centered. They're focused on getting relief. And I'm telling you to beware of them. One example, if you have a parent that just doesn't want to stop being controlling of you, you can just lower contact, if necessary, break all contact. Don't enforce boundaries. Say what you won't accept and what you do accept. Don't do that. The parent knows very well that the parent's going too far. The parent is just narcissistic. I'm not saying your parent is a narcissist, but he or she is narcissistic. The only thing that matters is his or her own comfort. And they think they have the right and they are entitled to use you for their own comfort anytime they want. And that's not the case. Such people will become demonic vessels over time. They'll become bitter and enraged once they can't get the relief from you. And since they can't use for relief, I mean. So, don't force boundaries and all of that BS. Just lower contact, if necessary, break all contact. I'm not telling you to just disappear like people in the world do. Just avoid stuff. You deal with stuff by being practical. Worldly people, when they are fed up, they just disappear. You don't even hear from them anymore. And you just have to find a way to deal with what they do. I'm not telling you to do that. I'm telling you to be responsible. See the situation for what it really is. Too many of you are dealing with stuff on the world's terms. That's why you remain stuck. Me, I lower contact, and if necessary, I break all contact. And if people keep pushing, I tell them as it is. If someone's not reliable, I tell them you're not reliable. If I can't trust someone, I tell them I don't trust you. Now look, you don't have to be that direct as I am. Being direct can be dangerous in some situations because some people just can't handle facts. When you're direct with them, they explode. They get out of line. So I'm not telling you, you don't have to be direct as I am. Remember, I'm a man. Men tend to be direct. At least, that's to be expected. But okay, just understand that some people you can't negotiate with them. You can't figure things out with them. There's no reasoning with them. Why? Because they're only concerned with themselves. They will always find an excuse for why they are neglecting their responsibilities towards you. Because it's always about them and them alone. Look, maybe this is the last time I'm saying this in a remind video, because this year I'm making remind videos only. I mentioned it before. So I'm going to extend it a little bit. Now I'm going to address the women now. Ladies, if you have a friend or an associate and you notice that suddenly she doesn't have any contact with you, and this is if she's forgotten about all of you, and then you found out just a guy she's involved with, I'm telling you, when you find out that a friend of yours, or maybe a relative, or maybe an acquaintance, or it can even be your sibling, when you notice that she totally forgotten about all of you, just because there's a guy in her life, I'm telling you, that's a big red flag. Look, when you have teenagers, 10, 12 years old doing this, it's understandable. They're new in their in all of that. Their hormones just began to develop. But once someone is past the age of 20 and they still act this way, that's not cute, that's not childish, that's negative. Let me tell you why. Anyone past the age of 20 understands that human beings need each other. So also their significant other, their crush needs others. They need others. They will understand as a human being, you need to function with others. So no one past the age of 20 that uses their mind, whether male or female, would act in such a disgraceful manner. I mean, ladies, if you have a friend like that, or colleague, if you have someone, a female associate in your life that acts this way, what she is revealing with her attitude is that she is only concerned with her own comfort. She doesn't care about you nor anyone else. She found a guy whom she can feed off, So she's feeding off of him. When that guy was not around, she feeds off the positive attention she got from you. So the whole time she was feeding off of you. It's now that she found a better supply that her attitude reveals what she was really doing. You thought she was a friend or she was a relative that she, you thought something else. Now you see how she really is. So what do you do now? Lower contact. Don't trust her. Seriously, if a woman past the age of 20 behaves in such a way, it's disgraceful. I mean, just think about it. She forgets everyone else. Nobody else matters, just her crush. She becomes totally codependent upon the guy, wants to control the guy, and she may even lie to the guy about you just to get his sympathy. And what if the guy is a maniac or someone out of his mind? Then later, she wants to come back and cry and want sympathy from you. The same people she dumped because she got attention from that guy. Yeah, someone can be infatuated. That exists, I understand that. And if you're infatuated with someone and there's contact from both sides, of course you want a lot of contact, you want to be with them, but that's just a very short-lived phase. And even during that short-lived phase, you still realize other people also exist. People have become grown. People have become accustomed to this behavior. Also the conditioning of the media in Hollywood, and people just accept it as normal. But I'm telling you, it's not normal, it's not even natural. It's a red flag. Such an individual is willing to go very far to maintain their supply. I mean, supply being emotional supply. I'm telling you, such people are dangerous. Such people will enable harm. They'll betray you. I told you before to beware of people that are secretive without a proper context. Well, that's really what this is about. If she got involved with the guy and she really liked the guy, she should have been open about it so people know who the guy is. So that let's say her name is Joanna and she meets Richard. Let's say she talks with Richard, how great she thinks Richard is, all of that. Then all of you can see who this Richard is. Now, if there's something wrong with Richard, you can alert her saying, Joanna, I don't think this Richard is a good idea. Okay, then you know what I'm saying here? But if she gets involved with Richard, she doesn't even tell everyone. She's so into Richard, she forgets about everyone else, she doesn't even care about anyone else. But at the same time, she expects people to be there for her. Look, such an individual has gone too far already. Don't take such an individual back as if nothing ever happened. Unless individual faces himself, unless she looks for deliverance, don't trust her again. I'm telling you, don't. Men, the same counts for you. If you have a buddy, or a friend, or a male coworker, whoever, who suddenly disappears because he's involved with some chick, I'm telling you, that's a red flag. I'm not just addressing the women, I'm addressing the men also. If you have a guy behaving like that and he's past the age of 20, I'm telling you, it's a big red flag. But when a man does it, people notice it immediately. And people tend to address him. When women do it, people tend to excuse it. Well, I'm telling you, in both cases, it's a red flag. Don't ignore it. Well, it's morning, I woke up on this free day, making this message for you. I mean, recording this message. Please learn from it. I have many videos on this channel in case I alert people about red flags. Please don't miss them. Don't miss the red flags. Many people end up in very dangerous situations because there were red flags that were so obvious that they didn't notice. Now, it can happen that you didn't notice something. I'm not going to blame you nor condemn you, nor point a finger at you, but just learn, grow, and be alert. And I'm going to repeat, and I'm going to close this video. Anyone who dumps you, whether verbally, directly, or indirectly by avoiding contact with you, just because you got involved with some significant other, and they become isolated with that individual, I'm telling you, it's a red flag. And don't blame it on the significant other. Only it's individual, him or herself, that complies with it. Look, such folks, when they come back to you, it's only to get relief and to feed off of you. They have no interest in repenting, no interest in your well-being on long term. They're not even interested in how they treated you and how what they did to you. You just have to understand it and throw it behind you. But anytime they feel uncomfortable, they have the right to recall all things of the past and throw you out. They can will whatever they will, but you have to behave. Don't fall for this. Agree with Christ.